Hey, I'm Vinny, this is Makeify. I just got a new table saw. It's my very first table saw, but I have nowhere to put it. So I made this cart with wheels for the table saw, and I made a second cart just like the first, but taller so that it's the same height as the bed of the table saw. So I can use this as an outfeed table or just another work surface. And I'm gonna show you how I made them. To make both carts, I used 6 8-foot-long 2x4s, a quarter sheet of 3/4-inch thick plywood, and a quarter sheet of 1/2-inch thick plywood. I cut the 2x4s into smaller pieces with a small circular saw. I used a speed square to keep the cuts perfectly square. There are a lot of ways to cut 2x4s. This is just the way I've done it before, and it works for me. I ended up with 8 pieces that were 21 inches long, 8 pieces that were 17 inches long. These pieces were used to make the top and bottom frames of the carts. I also cut 4 pieces that were 18.5 inches long, and these were the legs for the shorter cart. And I cut 4 pieces that were 31 1/8 inches long, and these were the legs for the taller cart. I cut each of the 2 pieces of plywood into 2 smaller pieces. Each of which was 24 by 20 inches. These 4 pieces were used as the tops and bottoms of the carts. To make the top and bottom frames of the carts, I screwed 2 21-inch long 2x4s together with 2 17-inch long 2x4s. I drilled pilot holes to prevent the wood from splitting. And I used 2 2.5-inch long screws in each joint. I also countersunk the pilot holes so the screw heads wouldn't protrude from the surface of the wood. I made a total of 4 of these frames. To make the shorter cart, I screwed the 4 18 1/8-inch long 2x4s to the outside of one of the frames. Again, I used 2 screws in each piece. I had to be careful not to drive a screw into any of the screws in the frame. Then I screwed the 4 legs into a second frame piece in the same way. I placed one of the 3/4-inch thick plywood pieces onto the top of the cart and attached it to the frame with 4 screws. Then I flipped the cart and screwed one of the 1/2-inch thick plywood pieces to the other side. I used 1/2-inch plywood for the bottom just to save weight and cost, but you could use 3/4-inch on the top and bottom if you wanted. I got 4 locking casters and screwed them to the 4 corners on the bottom of the cart. I used 2-inch casters that will each support 88 pounds, so the cart should be able to hold about 350 pounds total. I constructed the taller cart in exactly the same way, but I used the 31 1/8-inch long 2x4s for the legs. I have plans that you can download for free if you want to make these carts, or if you just want to see my design and modify it to suit your needs. There's a link down in the video description to those plans. There are also links in the description for the supplies and tools I used. These are Amazon affiliate links, So if you click on one and then buy anything on Amazon, Amazon will give me a little bit of a kickback. It won't cost you anything extra, but it does help me make new videos. I'm really happy with the way the carts turned out. They were easy to make and pretty inexpensive. I like how they move around on the casters. You can use this bottom shelf for storage. And they're really strong. I hope you liked this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe to keep up to date with my newest videos or check out my other channel, Makeify 2. If you really like the things I do, you can support me on Patreon, just like my top Patreon supporter, Michael Thomas. Thank you, Michael. I'd also like to thank the mystery person who bought me this saw. Thank you, whoever you are. And thank you for watching. I made a second table. What am I gonna say? It's not a sawdust around here. Exact same height as the table. No, what is this? It's a table saw. As an outfeed table or just a, I'm not looking at the camera. And I'm gonna show you how I made them. Ooh, wow. We'll get it right this time. I hope you liked this video. If you did, ooh. You can also subscribe to keep up to date with my newest videos. You think I could say this by now, but I'd also like to thank the mystery person who bought me this saw. Ooh. That wasn't bad.